Welcome to Comprehensive Current Affairs presented by Narayana IAS Academy. The Northeast Monsoons. The onset of Northeast Monsoon was marked by widespread rainfall across the state of Tamil Nadu. Let us now try to understand the Northeast Monsoons. Every year, in the month of September and October, the intertropical convergence zone moves from the northern hemisphere into the southern hemisphere. Therefore, the northern Indian landmass will cool down, thereby creating a high pressure system, whereas the surrounding Indian Ocean will remain warm, therefore it is a low pressure system. The pressure difference between the north and the south will draw winds from the Himalayas, the Indo-Gangetic Plain, over the Bay of Bengal into the Indian Ocean. While these winds travel over the Bay of Bengal, they pick up a lot of moisture, and this moisture falls as rain over state of Tamil Nadu and many parts of southern peninsular India. It is reported that 50 to 60% of rainfall of Tamil Nadu is received during this period, as Tamil Nadu is in the rain shadow region during the southwest monsoons. The centralized selection mechanism. This may be important from the prelims point of view, therefore try to remember the facts. Article 233 to Article 237 in the Part 4 of the Constitution deals with organization of subordinate courts and to ensure their independence from the state executive. The provisions in the contention now are appointment of district judge and other judges. Generally, the judges in the subordinate courts are appointed by governor of the state in consultation with High Court and State Public Service Commission. The problem here is that at present there are 5,000 judicial posts lying vacant in the lower judiciary. This is contributing to the pendency of the cases, therefore making Indian judicial system inefficient. The Supreme Court on Thursday cautioned the states that if they do not take any measures regarding this, the Supreme Court would resort to a centralized selection mechanism for appointment of judges in the states. Moving on, China-Pakistan. Bus service. A new bus service will be launched between Pakistan and China under the flagship China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. This bus service will start from Lahore, which is right next to Wagha border, and from there on it will pass through Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, especially through Gilgit-Baltistan, while reaching a Xinjiang province in China. India registered its sovereignty concerns with China and Pakistan because Gilgit-Baltistan and Pakistan-occupied Kashmir is legitimately the territory of India. However, China has termed that the bus service is only to improve the economic relationship between the both country and its foreign policy and defense policy towards the state of Jammu and Kashmir and Pakistan-occupied Kashmir did not change. LMDC and BASIC. LMDC means like-minded developing countries, which consists of India, China, Venezuela and Iran. And BASIC means Brazil, South Africa, India and China. These are networks of developing countries to bring consensus of their needs and to project their needs to the developed world. The like-minded developing countries and BASIC countries are meeting in this month to discuss the provisions in the upcoming Conference of Parties in Poland. The Conference of Parties in Poland will decide on the implementation of the Paris Treaty on the climate change to attain or to limit the greenhouse gases, which will lead to the limitation of global warming up to 2 degrees centigrade. The main provisions that both these developing countries are discussing are the finance part and the technology part. Financially, the developed countries firstly accepted to give a donation of $100 billion to GEF and GCF. And technologically, many of the technologies for mitigating and adapting to climate change are with the developed countries but not with the developing countries. Many of the developed countries, especially United States of America after Donald Trump became president, are moving away from their intended commitments given during COP Paris. In this regard, the developing countries are meeting to discuss their concerns and stand united while demanding their rights with developed countries. NRI deposits surge. The non-residential Indian deposits jumped from $5.7 billion in the first 5 months of this fiscal. The reason behind this is that the rupee value has slid by over 9 to 10 rupees. And secondly, whenever the rupee value depreciates, the interest rates in the country develop an upside bias. Therefore, if the NRIs bring their money from outside India to inside India, they can get more interest rates. Along with that, the government and RBI have taken measures in the past to attract higher quantum of NRI deposits because this will increase the foreign exchange reserve of the country. Therefore, the NRI deposits are freely repatriable, that is, they can be taken out of India at any point of time, and secondly, they are tax-free. However, there are some concerns while dealing with NRI deposits. These are: any sharp upsurge in these deposits over a short period of time may not be necessarily favorable because these deposits can be taken out of the country at any point of time, leading to sudden currency outflows. USA revokes duty-free imports. To understand this, first we need to understand what is generalized system of preferences. United States of America trade program is designed to help the developing and developed countries of the world to improve their economic production in their country by exporting their goods to United States at free of duty, that is, they do not pay any treaty. Under this provision, up to 4,800 products from 129 designated beneficiary countries are allowed into the United States of America. However, under the Donald Trump administration, they are bringing many changes. The first change is that 90 products from many countries which were so far duty-free under the generalized system of preferences were removed from the list. The revoked in the list of revoked products, at least 50 products are Indian. However, these products can be exported to USA under most favored nation rates which are given in WTO. How does this impact India? India is one of the largest beneficiaries of generalized system of preferences. Every year, India exports up to $5.6 billion worth of goods into United States of America. What are these goods? Many of these goods are agriculture products and handloom products, which will especially affect MSME and primary sector in Indian economy. Thank you. See you tomorrow.